Thank you for joining us for another episode of Team Superheroes. I am stoked about today's session. I'll let my esteemed guest here introduce himself, if you would.
Hey, I'm Phecda. I'm a program manager on Microsoft Teams, and I specifically focus on the Teams and Channels area on how we can get our team owners to be successful at creating good teams.
So, dude, I spend a lot of time talking to customers about what you guys are doing. I think it's one of the coolest things that we have on Teams. Can you maybe fill in those watching what you're working on right now?
Yeah, so I mean, at a high level, kind of, my goal is to look at all the feature set and all the capabilities that Teams has in helping team owners, team leaders set up successful digital collaboration spaces. That's you know, really the end goal. And part of that, you know, manifests itself in some of the work that we're doing in the team creation experience, all the way to some of the more exciting things that I think we're going to be talking about more today is on the developer side, on how do we kind of help developers build these kind of templatized teams that ensure that these collaboration spaces are successful day zero once they're created.
And you guys, we call these templates, right? Teams templates. Yeah. So, types of templates that are out there. I mean, I love that background. It's make everybody's life easier. I actually, the way I think about it too, and correct me if you feel differently, is for the average person jumping into Teams on day one, how do we lower that barrier for adoption? How do we make it more consistent and familiar where you see the people you're familiar with, you know, the teams that you're a part of, the applications that you use every day? But maybe if you could give everybody a little bit of background on the types of templates that we're enabling right now.
Yeah. So you know, one of the awesome things about Teams is that the collaboration spaces that we enable team owners to create can be very, very flexible. You know, they can create teams with a very rich set of channels, apps, and tabs. And you know, we have a tendency of having too much capability that ends up kind of confusing some of the team owners. So templates as a concept actually started in the Teams education space, where when a teacher goes and creates a team, we rather than leading with all the, hey, you can, you know, name your team and all the different capabilities, we actually led with scenarios. So in the education space, we have these three types of templates, the class, the staff, and the PLC templates. And what we found was, like, by leading with scenarios and setting up these teachers with a creation experience that starts them off with an intent, really help kind of help them kind of have the right mindset on figuring out how do I want to continue setting up this space. So the class team template type is a great example, one of our most popular template types, where when you go and create this team out of the box, you get things like the assignments app installed and a class notebook, which is kind of the core kind of workloads that a teacher and a student would use to go and collaborate and teach education.
Dude, you're my spirit animal. I can't tell you how often we're having this conversation around scenarios, right? And we get asked this question from customers all the time, you know, because we'll get these technically savvy folks who love Teams and they're bought into it and they get it. It's how do I bring everybody else along? How do I get them to see it? And you know, the feedback I always give is give people reasons. Lead with those scenarios versus this is just a chat meeting and calling tool, right? Because it's much more than that. But real quick, so you started with education. That's really cool. I didn't know this is where it started. But we've evolved that to also meet enterprise organizations and other types of organizations. Can you talk a little about you know, the different types of templates that we might have available for folks?
Yeah. So on the developer side, we have kind of two additional categories of templates. So I talked about the education one, but we're starting to look into various vertical industries. So retail is a space that we're really interested in. Healthcare is another one that's been really big. In the retail space, we have these template types like the store template. Mm-hmm. You can imagine it's a digital manifestation of your store collaboration experience. Everything from the part-time worker, full-time workers, and the management staff that manages a retail space, all the way to we have these like manager templates and regional manager templates for managing multiple retail locations. On the healthcare side, we have kind of similar concepts as well. We have a template for hospital wards, specifically for a ward, and the idea is that these doctors and lead nurses who are trying to create these, again, similar digital collaboration spaces for the different working groups that they have, they can leverage some of these templates. And that's just kind of the big beginning of our journey of templates, we envision kind of a platform, if you will, where we're going to have a set of awesome first-party or Microsoft-created templates that help kind of guide some of these different types of team leaders in creating the right collaboration space. But eventually, we want to extend that platform so that any developer or even business decision makers within an organization can contribute to, you know, this growing set of team templates.
That's awesome. Expanding it beyond the developer, yeah. Mm-hmm. So if awesome news, if I'm a retail organization, educational institution, healthcare, if I'm not one of those organizations, do I have an option to leverage templates today?
Yeah, so you do. So outside of the Microsoft created templates, you can actually fully customize the creation of teams today. I wouldn't call them full-fledged templates yet, just because you can't really save them, but if you ever review some of our developer graph APIs, if you look at like the Create Team API, it's actually pretty extensive. So with the recent release in February 2019, we basically extended the Create Team graph API to not only allow you to create a team, but you can predefine what kind of channels you want in the team, the set of apps you want to have pre-installed after the team is created, and even have a set of tabs that are pre-pinned in those channels. And what we found is that by leading with this kind of templatized creation of teams, it really relieves the burden on the team owner to figure out, hey, how do I ensure that I have consistent digital collaboration spaces that also fit the scenarios I really want, and ensure that my day zero experience, once I invite members into this digital collaboration space, it's clear what the intent is and what and in what format they should be collaborating.
I love that, because I think of it as day zero, like to your point. My first time I get on Teams, I've got consistency, I've got familiarity. But then when I jump onto new teams inside of Teams and new projects, it's consistent in the approach that we've structured teams and channels, or at least we give that capability with templates, right? Which I find incredibly valuable, because then you don't need to spend time figuring out how to get work done. It's ready to go. And you can just pop in and you inherently know how to actually start working and get your job done. No, I love that. To get this information and get started, is this on our doc site right now?
Yeah. So we have some basic documentation that just talks about the scope of the capabilities we have as part of templates. So you can definitely read that, I guess, in the links below later on. And we also have, as I mentioned, Microsoft has published a set of kind of starter templates. But the more extensive, awesome stuff is actually in our graph documentation, which goes into even more details on all the specific properties that you as a developer can use to go and set and create these templates. So definitely check those out.
Awesome. So now you kind of touched on it briefly. Can we get a little bit of insight on what you're doing next and what the
rest? Yeah. So as I mentioned, you know, we're taking a very kind of platform, long-term play in templates. So the things that you see that's been, you know, published online right now is very developer-focused. Definitely not meant for, you know, your typical IT admin or even a business decision maker that might not be as technical. But the eventual goal is that we want to extend this platform to A, not only allow Microsoft to go and publish more awesome, rich templates that map to business scenarios, but we also want to enable our partners or consultants and even IT admin to go define, hey, what is a template? What is the right, you know, patterns and practices we want to adopt as an organization, and have those kind of surface to end users? And then ultimately, our end goal is that we empower every single team owner and team creator to not only create their own templates, but eventually share those templates with fellow peers within their organization. So, you know, in the teacher scenario, you can imagine a grade one math teacher comes up with the ideal, you know, digital workspace for teaching whatever, the math 101 class. That teacher, you know, our vision is that we want to empower that teacher to be able to create that template and share that template with their fellow teachers across, you know, a school district. And you can see that applying to, you know, retail leaders or other business decision makers within an organization, really just share that knowledge that exists as the best patterns and practices within
that. That is awesome. I love that. I mean, you're cloning your creation, right? Mm-hmm, essentially. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think about this from a partner perspective. This is where I'd be spending a lot of time if I was a partner, particularly those who focus on adoption and change management, because we know so much effort is being put into that right now. And not even just a partner, right? The partners within an organization who also look after change management for these organizations. What an incredible opportunity to create this great, almost, I think of it as an employee life cycle experience in teams, right? Like day one to week one to month one to year one. And what do these all look like and how do they evolve? Okay, I know you've been working on this for a while. I guess last thing I'd ask you here, and thank you, by the way, it's all been insanely valuable, Any advice looking back that you give people listening in, on what to think about when they're getting started and maybe things to leverage?
So I think definitely as the author of a template, if you're kind of going to explore some of the documentation we have, is really get to know and understand the constructs that we've put forward with teams, with channels, with apps and tabs. Understand all the basic Lego building blocks, if you will, on how you can, you know, build a successful team. But don't stop there. Once you understand the various building blocks that you can go and apply within the digital collaboration space, also understand how your end users, your owners, your members of a team work on a day-to-day basis. Because by understanding the workflows that they embody, both physically and in their day-to-day lives, being able to map that to the constructs that Microsoft Teams provides, you can really make a connection and build really rich templates that, again, the idea is that day zero when they're onboarded, it's clear to them that these are the different places they should have conversations, these are tools they can leverage to go and get their work done. And having a deep understanding of both these spaces prior to you know starting creating and deploying your first set of templates within your organization, I think is super valuable and super important to the success of these experiences.
No, that's killer. I mean, I guess if I can summarize that, correct me if I didn't catch this correctly, it's definitely spending the time to create a template that fits your organization as it is today on day zero, but also recognizing that that will evolve and you'll learn a ton. Because we also see this big maturity curve in teams with a lot of customers, right? They get on, they start to use some of the basics, and then things start to explode in a very positive way. And you see all these crazy cool use cases that, to your point, one day we'll be able to clone and leverage across an organization. I find that really powerful. The work you guys are doing is amazing, dude. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Hopefully everybody here on the call learned something and goes and leverages templates today. But appreciate your time, Phecda.
Yeah, good luck with templates.